It was one of those days. It was one of those days where the sunshine blew air kisses onto the river and it gleamed. My mother and I sitting on the edge of its sandy horizon, where dirt splits water and grass like the prophet Moses. My mother's hijab hugs her head the same way she cradles me and my sister. We stare into the river, only ever daring to make eye contact through water. I watch her image the same way I do executions. She pulls the pin from her hijab, stabs it into the dirt, trying to find some way to hurt this land back, unravels her scarf, unwinding a 20-year-old marriage to her religion, lets it drift through the wind, her hand-shaped limp still lingering through the air. My mother giving her life back to its creator, watching her weep into the river so there is no evidence she had ever cried. But my tears proof enough, a white supremacist becomes president, and the first thing my mother does is give up, and I am saddened down to the bone, an unjust arthritis crippling us both, the whole nation in a coma, and my mother weeping at its bedside for all her nameless sisters in hijabs and their daughters and hers. And I am saddened and I am shameful because my mother does not quit. My mother runs over oceans for her children. She does not weep into rivers. Mom, I am not saying it's not okay to give up. I am just saying when you do, make sure your hand is a claw. Make sure their skin finds home in your fingernails, that you staple your hijab to the nape of your neck before you ever let them take it. The us Muslim women do not get buried without digging ourselves back out. Us Muslim women do not flinch at the name of a white man. Us Muslim women do lose faith sometimes, but us Muslim women got a love for Allah like boomerangs. The minute it leaves, it is already on its way back. Today we may give up. Today our hijabs may drift in the river, but tomorrow when we do, we'll do the cleansing before we pray. And we turn the faucet on to worship Allah for the fifth time that day. Our white hijabs will seep out, tear-soaked and wrinkled, but still as wearable as they have always been. And we will let their president know that 20 years of faith do not blow in the wind that easily.